The pillars of the society. Socrates. Socrates lived at Athens in Greece from 469 BCE to 399 BCE. He was a truthful person. He was a philosopher. His philosophy was to find the truth. He believed that all vice is the result of ignorance and virtue is knowledge. According to him, no person is willingly bad, and persons who know the right will act rightly. His disciple Plato and Plato's disciple Aristotle narrated Socrates' thoughts in their writings. Though his thoughts influenced many thinkers, many of his contemporaries disliked his attitude towards the Athenian state and their religion. So, he was tried in a court twice. Firstly, he was charged with neglecting gods. Then, he was charged with corrupting the morals of the young. Socrates was sentenced to death. His friends planned his escape from prison. But he did not do that. He spent his last day with his friends, and in the last, he calmly drank a cup of hemlock poison and died. Abraham Lincoln. Abraham Lincoln was born on 12th February 1809 in an ordinary family of America. He was the 16th president of the USA. He ended the system of slavery from his country, but he had to sacrifice his life for it. Lincoln had less than one full year of formal education in his entire life. But his desire to learn and his efforts made him self-educated. He said that there can be no moral right to a man to make another man his slave. All men should be treated in an equal manner. When he was elected the President of the USA, the people of southern states were against Lincoln because they feared that he would abolish slavery. He fought against slavery. He was elected president for second term. John Wilkes Booth shot Abraham Lincoln dead. On that day, Lincoln and his wife went to the Ford's Theater. Booth put his pistol to Lincoln's head and killed him. Karl Marx. Karl Marx was a great thinker. He was born in Trier, Germany in 1818. He was educated at universities of Bonn, Berlin and Jena. Karl Marx adopted communist beliefs. In 1845, he was forced to leave Paris because of his revolutionary activities. He settled in Brussels and organized communist correspondence committees in various cities of Europe. He wrote the Communist Manifesto with Friedrich Engels. He mentioned the confrontation between the capitalist, the rich, and the working class in it. He said that the capitalists exploit the working class to become rich. He believed that the capitalist class would be overthrown by a worldwide working class revolution. As a result, there would be a classless society. So, he engaged in motivating the working class to go against the capitalist class. He also wrote Das Kapital. After his death, Marx's thoughts, ideas and theories were widely accepted and came to known as Marxism. His philosophy was developed and applied by Vladimir Lenin that continued to influence the 20th century. Mahatma Gandhi. Mahatma Gandhi was born on 2nd October 1869 in Gujarat, India. He was married to Kasturba when he was 13 years old. He went to England to study law and worked as a barrister in South Africa. That time, the white people ruled South Africa. Many Indians also worked in South Africa. The white behaved very badly with Indians also. Indians were denied the civil liberties and political rights. Seeing the condition of Indians, Gandhiji started a movement called Satyagraha. Gandhiji threw himself into the struggle for elementary rights for Indians. He suffered imprisonment many times. Then he adopted a unique method of struggle called Satyagraha for Indian rights. After staying for 20 years in South Africa, Gandhiji returned to India with his unique method of Satyagraha. He studied the conditions of Indians. He became very unhappy seeing the poverty in the country. He also found people being extremely exploited and tortured by the British. So, he adopted a simple life and started to oppose the British rule. He applied his unique method of Satyagraha based on non-violence and played the most vital role in the freedom struggle. Under his leadership, India became free on 15th August 1947. Gandhiji applied his principles of truth, non-violence and courage throughout his life. He lived a spiritual and ascetic life of prayer, meditation and fasting. The death of the father of the nation was regarded as an international catastrophe. It is very sad that Nathuram Godse, another Indian, murdered the father of Indian nation. Martin Luther King. Martin Luther King was born on 15th January 1929 at Atlanta. He was a black American. Though slavery was abolished by Lincoln, but blacks were still badly treated. Martin Luther was humiliated at many places because he was a black American. Blacks were not allowed to sit in buses until all the whites had been seated. To remove all these differences, Martin Luther met many political and religious leaders in the world. He followed the path of non-violence of Mahatma Gandhi. He was awarded Jawaharlal Nehru Peace Award for the service he did for the black Americans. He was awarded the Nobel Prize for Peace in 1964. He was assassinated in 1968. He lived and died for high human values.